and gentlemen, our second contest of the evening. Introducing first, heading over the blue corner, representing Next Generation MMA from Liverpool, Joe Neal.
Thank you.
3-4, 3-3 rounds, and a semi-professional rules. Introducing first, signing out of the blue corner, representing Next Generation MMA from Liverpool, Joe Lee!
Riotous applause here for the crowd favourite Jake Barrett in the black and camouflage shorts, taking on another very talented youngster from Next Generation in Joe Neal in the black and white shorts.
Looks like there'll be no love lost here.
There certainly doesn't seem to be a lot, does there?
No.
Certainly does not seem to be a lot.
I'll try and refrain myself from being a bit biased towards my teammates here.
It's the key of a good commentator, my friend. You'll get it. You'll get it. So Jake comes out. There's a nice leg kick there. Joe Neal throws a huge shot. Jake's earned some good head movement. A nice knee from Neal there.
Caught him flush.
These two look like they're just ready to go in there and throw punches.
It's going to be one of them fights. It's going to be a bit of a brawl here.
Huge overhand there.
Jake needs to get his guard up.
He's sort his distance out. You're right. Joe Neal coming in there.
Both throwing big bombs here.
Of the most technical strikes I've ever seen in my entire life. both fighters going there throwing heavy leather.
Looks like they both won't finish it.
Neal takes the leg and looks to go down to the ground if he can get the takedown, working for the single leg.
He's working really hard for that. Jake ain't letting him know.
And as we saw in the last fight, one thing we see from the Next Generation lads is that wrestling is relentless. Jake looks like he's got the neck, but it's going to be hard to finish from this situation as Neal does the right thing to fight the hands. Barrett coming forward.
Goes to the takedown again, stuffs it.
Great takedown defense from Jake there. Very impressive. But Neal is relentless in pursuing that takedown. He's got the single. He's got his man up, straining the double. Beautiful.
Good takedown. He kept working, kept pressure on, kept working for it, and took him down in the end.
What I like as well was he made sure the head was safe and he posted his legs so he didn't take his man down and end up straight in guard.
He's in mount now. Is he in mount or I'd like to see from this angle? No, he's in half guard.
Jake explodes up, but he's got to watch the neck. Joe Neal's got a good hold of it. He may use it to rotate or spin around the back if he can. This is a dangerous position for Barrett to be in.
He's got to prove you.
Peruvian necktie, and this time maybe I called it right. It is a Peruvian necktie he's gone for there.
It's on very tight.
That looks incredibly tight.
Jake doesn't want tap though.
He doesn't want a tap, but he might not have a choice.
Brilliant escape.
He's done well to fight out there. Unusual position now as both come forward. If Jake rotates around, he could end up in side control.
He's left his neck out again.
Neal's done the right thing.
Neal knows that.
Jake's maybe going to be looking for the double leg himself if he can get it. Joe Neal's got a hold of the neck, but it's very loose.
And he's taken down.
Explosive takedown from Barrett there. Very well done. He's got to watch that arm there, though.
Very good explosive fighting, isn't it?
Got to watch the triangle choke on the left arm, Conrad. If you can post that leg through, you can see that's what he's fighting for.
Let's be very careful here, because with the mean down tight, it could lock on very quickly. And that'll be the end of the night. But he does well, he's got away.
Nice
big up kick.
Nice up kick.
It's a big punch. He's left his arm in, though.
Big shots coming through from Barrett.
He's looking for the triangle. Neal is on the bottom.
He looks for the triangle. Now he's transitioned very nicely. That's a good call, Conrad.
He's on tight there. He's left his weight all the way down in that.
End of the round.
Good first round. There
very good first. Very close first round as well.
I'm not sure where I'd edge at the minute, if I'm honest with you.
Nah, it's a very tough one to score. I mean, both fighters certainly had the moments.
They both got the bits in the stand up and they both got a takedown.
Yeah, they both got a takedown. I mean, for me, Neal looked the most dangerous on the floor. I can certainly see. If you had to edge it in one kind of dimension, they were pretty even. Yeah. But Neal did have a submission attempt.
Yeah, it would have to edge slightly towards Neal. They both got good striking at the start. They both got a takedown. But Neal went for them submissions. That could just edge it that slight way. He went for the Peruvian there. He went for that triangle as well.
That Peruvian looked really tight.
Very tight.
But called it right this time. It was, was actually a Peruvian rather than the hybrid rear naked choke that you had last time I was commentating for Gladiator Promotions.
Don't know what that was myself, man.
So as the coach's exit for the second round. What an action-packed first round. Here's hoping the second's anything like as good as the first was.
Hopefully they've still got a lot left in the tank to show us.
Gladiator Gym's own Jake Barrett. Black and camouflage. Shorts in the red corner there. Next Generation's Joe Neal. Black shorts coming out the blue corner. You've got to think, Conrad, as well, both fighters will have a real measure of respect for each other now, knowing they've both put each other through those tough situations.
Yeah.
Neil throwing a shot over the top there. A bit sloppy on that.
Jake, I'm liking Jake's bit of head movement. He's avoiding some punishment well.
It's shooting straight
Neil
into the single leg.
Takedown again.
He's got hold of that single leg if he can keep working. Jake's got some good shots.
Sprawled on him well, but is he in Neil's? Relentless, and he finishes that takedown again.
That's exactly the right word. That is relentless. And what I like he's done there is he's pushed Jake up against the cage, and he's really going to struggle to work from this angle.
For me, he's doing really well with these takedowns, Neil. You see a lot of guys, they attempt a takedown and then they get stuffed and they back up and stop, go away, but he's continually pushing forward. And he's relentless. He just really wants to take this guy down.
He's looking to pass that arm as well, maybe for a mounted triangle. And so often we see, like you say, with the good wrestlers, you don't stop when you hit the guy, you stop when the guy hits the fence or the floor.
Exactly, yeah, and that seems to be Neil's plan. He's got him trapped here, he's got an arm trapped, and he's got him in crucifix position, throwing away shots. Jake needs to do something here. He can't sit there and take the shots all day.
Certainly can't sit in the crucifix position. And Joe Neal showing us a really good game here. He's isolated that arm nicely, but Barrett does well to get it back through. And now he'll have to work and try and use those hips to get out of this tough situation.
For me, he's got the fence right behind him. Should use that to wall walk up the cage and get back to his feet. For me, Barrett's having the success. He's having a better time on his feet than he is on the floor.
Yeah, I think you're right there. But to be fair to him, the bulk of the time when he's been on the floor, Joe Neal's put a lot of pressure on him. And he's in the half guard situation now. I mean, if Joe Neal can posture up and maybe land some shots, he could do some damage.
Oh, there's a good sweep.
Good sweep from Jake Barrett there. Really good sweep.
You know, he's now going to want to put punishment back on him for what he's taken. Let's see what he can do.
But I mean, with these semi-pro fights, these shorter rounds, I mean, in a pro fight, that series of events that happened wouldn't have taken that much of the round. But at this time, it's a bigger, much bigger percentage of the round.
You've got to do something quick when you get these opportunities, and he's landing some hard shots inside the head.
Here we go again, the relentless wrestling. Will it come to the fore of Joe Neal? And it has. I think you hit the nail on the head with the word relentless there, Conrad. Joe Neal has shown us a really grinding wrestling game.
Jake's looking for a guillotine.
Arm and guillotine, more of a crank than a choke. A very tough fight, a very tough submission to finish.
Looks tight though from here, a minute. O'Neill needs to go up on his tiptoes now and pop his head out.
Fight the hands, which he's done there. And from this situation, what he needs to do is land some ground and pound if he can. And there's the end of the round. Another very close one, Conrad. Who'd be a judge? It's a tough call on fights like this.
Yeah. When they're back and forth, it's sort of tough to call, but I'm going to have to edge slightly towards Neil again. He got
that
two takedowns.
Yeah, do you think? I'd say for me, Barrett potentially two rounds in the hole here. I mean, he's done nothing wrong. He's come out very well. I just think Joe Neal showed a relentless wrestling game, and he's pushed forward every time. Like you say, the second there's a millimetre of daylight, Joe Neal's closed that gap down, and he's left Jake Barrett with no space to work in at all.
Yeah. Neil's definitely found his weakness. He's seen that he's been able to take his man down successfully, and he keeps doing it over and over and smothering his guy on the floor.
I mean, you'll know yourself, if you come out for a fight with a guy and you land that first takedown and you take him down when he's fresh, it must be a huge confidence boost, because you think to yourself, he's only going to get more tired. I can keep taking this guy down all day.
If you're the guy on top, you're never going to be as tired as the guy on the bottom. You know what I mean? If you're the guy on the bottom, you've got work to get your position better and not absorb this punishment and have the guy rolling all around on you and striking you. You don't sat there all day. But Neil's definitely found the game plan to follow. He'll keep taking you down and smothering. Luke's even in the stand-up, and he's doing the right thing for me. But.
With the crowd getting behind Jake there. In this third round, Jake Barrett, black and camouflage shorts, against Next Generation's Joe Neal in the black and white shorts.
He's gone for that takedown again, brilliant. Ducked under the shot and came straight through.
Well, a good reversal from Jake, used the momentum well.
Oh, big knee!
Huge knee and a huge shot over the top.
It's a huge knee. Flush right on the bottom.
Neil got his points down and Jake going
again. I think that might have rocked him, you know, man.
Jake looking to get his man's back. He's got to be careful of rolling in this position. Barrett looking to get his hooks in.
Is he getting turned? Oh, he's turned out very good by Neil.
I mean, that's in that situation. I mean, it's easy for us to sit here and say calmly, this is what he needs to do, but it takes a real cool head on your shoulders when somebody's got your back to effectively turn around and end up in the guard like that.
Yeah.
And from Joe Neal's point of view, I mean, if he can land enough shots from this position to show that he's working and avoid the fight being stood up, I mean, could he take this fight in your eyes, realistically? If he spends the rest of this round just grounding and pounding?
For me, personally, if he stays on top of him for the rest of this round, Neil's won. I feel he's won the first two rounds. I only edged him, but I feel he's won them. But we never know with these judges, you don't know. I mean, either way.
From Barrett's point of view, I mean, we can see he's locked the body triangle up from guard there, and that's often a tactic we see when fighters want the fight to get back stood up. I mean, Barrett, for that position, can't really attack off his back. No. You're really limiting what you can do when you lock a body triangle up like that.
Seems obvious. I think that is his best bet of finishing this fight, though, for Jake. He needs to be off on his feet. Although he did have a good chance at taking the back there.
But Joe Neal did the right thing rolling through, and a really good fight here. Very gutsy performance from both guys. Fans starting to get behind Jake once again, but he's going to need all our help. Obviously, we're talking as well, Conrad, two shorter rounds. You've got less time. You can't afford even less to spend time on the bottom like this.
Yeah. It's not like in a professional fight where you've got a lot more time to work with. The short amount of time you've got in these semi-pro fights, you've got to go for it. Go all broke all the way through.
You have. You've got to make the most of it. And from Neil's point of view, if you can stifle it, if you can stifle Barrett like this, I think that's the right word. If you can just kind of smother him, Clay Guida style, just stifle him, take him on top, land just enough shots not to get stood up, but enough shots to give his opponent damage and score, then I think he's got it for me.
Yeah. Like we can see now, he keeps it smothered, and then every now and again he'll throw a shot. It's like, there we go again. A few shots come through. Not massive shots, but it's enough to stop the ref from coming over, and standing him up.
And if you're scoring this round just based sheerly on percentages, probably 10-15% of it Jake Barrett was winning. The rest of it has been all Joe Neal from guard. He's got his man on top, and like you say, he's landing just enough shots to be scoring and not getting stood back up.
Yeah.
And surely that would have been the game plan.
Yeah, you could see that was the game plan. I think at the start that they might have been a bit different game plan. They both come out swinging, throwing alpha leather. As soon as he saw he could take him down, that was it then. He was all over it.
I think the fight rode itself at that point, like you say. As soon as he got that idea in his head that he was able to take him down, and then, like you say, he repeatedly took him down, I think that was the icing on the cake there for Joe Neal.
Well, we'll just have to wait and see what the judges say. Seen crazier things happen.
I've seen much crazier things happen.
All in all, very good fight, though.
Incredibly good fight. I mean, obviously, it's really set the standard. I mean, the last guy that approached the card that we had, a similar thing, like very well-matched fights, really good guys going in there and leaving it all on the line. And Jake Barrett, huge local support. But now it's not down to us, now it's down to the judges as we get the official announcement.
So, at the end of three rounds, we go to the judges, John Hand, Mark Millward, and Wayne Bradford. Decision, blue corner.
not a massively popular decision, but for me, the right one.
Yes, the right decision. Obviously, because Jake's got the big local support, they're a bit disappointed, but I think they can see it was a close fight. It was a close fight, really, those first two rounds. But for me, Joe Neal did just enough to win.
I think he did just enough to win as well, and I think, to sum it up, I mean, that one word simply was relentless. I think Neal kept pushing forward, and that's what won in the fight.